Preparation for listening. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 19 to 21.
For it is written, I'll destroy the wisdom of the wise and will bring.
Louder.
For it is written, I'll destroy the wisdom of the wise and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. Where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputer of this world? Hath not God made foolish the wisdom of this world? For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. For the Jews require a sign.
Okay. 21. What do you understand from that verse 21? You can put it indirectly. God knows something. What's that he knows? God knows that man with his wisdom will never know God. Worldly wisdom, he will never know God. Man does not have the capacity to know God in himself. Putting it a little more clearly, chapter 3, verse 18 to 20.
Let no man deceive himself. If any man among you thinks that he is wise in this age, he must become foolish so that he may become wise. For the wisdom of the world is foolishness before God, for it is written, he is the one who catches the wise in their craftiness.
So what is the preparation needed? Become? What do you want to become? Then it is excluded. Fools in the sense is not foolishness. Fools means here helplessness to know, accepting my helplessness, complete helplessness to know. Within me, I do not have ability to know God. What did the Lord Himself say about it? Matthew 11, 27.
All things have been committed to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal Him.
No one knows the Father except the Son, and to whom the Son chooses to reveal. So no one knows the Father except the Son. No one comes to the Father except through me. I am the way, the truth, and the life. So, accepting my helplessness to know, then what is the way? We come back to chapter 2, verse 8.
Which none of the rulers of his age knew, for had they known, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
See, at the time of when the Lord was on earth, in a group like this, he had performed miracles. One of the miracles was raising a paralyzed man and making him walk. We read that at that time many came from various parts of the land, Pharisees and leaders, to listen to him. They were all present there. Probably the Greek philosophers also there. He made it clear that he has authority to forgive sins and claiming that he is the Son of God, and made him walk also. Did anyone believe? They were all wise. Bible scholars, Greek philosophers. They did not understand him. If they would have understood, they would have not crucified him. Why did they not understand? 9th verse.
But as it is written in the scriptures, no one has ever seen this and no one has ever heard about it. No one has ever imagined what God has prepared for those who love him.
Can you read it again?
But as it is written in the scriptures, no one has ever seen this and no one has ever heard about it. No one has ever imagined what God has prepared for those who love him.
The realities of God are beyond human rational mind. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, it has not appeared in the mind of anyone. Isaiah 55:8-9.
For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
Even if when you fly in a plane at 40,000 feet, how high is this heaven? How high? You can reach and touch? No, I want you to think about it when the verse says, as the heavens are above the earth, unimaginable distance. So far is my thinking and your thinking, my ways and your ways, of which we say so lightly that I understood it. You understood it in your own way. Romans 11:33.
Oh, the depth of riches, both of wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgments and unfathomable are his ways.
Unsearchable, unfathomable. If you put a coin into the sea, can you think of getting it back? Unsearchable, unfathomable. MH has not been found so far. They have been searching it for years. Now they abandoned it, cannot be found. A big plane cannot be found. Unsearchable, unfathomable. Along with that, there are three questions. Can you read those questions also?
Verse 34, for who has known the mind of Lord, or who has become his counselor, or who has first given to him that it might be paid back to him again?
What is the answer? Who? No one. When you read these passages, what's your response? Do you fall down and worship God? Does it happen? You can read it and pass it on. And talk about it lightly. Oh Lord, how great thou art. These verses can keep you there and go on meditating on that, and something else will happen in us. My size will shrink so much. One of the VeggieTales stories, Joshua will be meeting the Lord of the captain of the army of the Lord. He'll be lying on the dust. Then he will raise his head like this and look. not even worthy to raise my head before you. I lay myself in the dust, Joshua and Job said. I have only heard about you, but I have seen you now, and lay myself in ashes. Before that, he was confident to ask many questions. Now, when God revealed little bit of himself, his working in the universe, Job says, no more, I will not speak anymore. He came silent. I lay my hands on my mouth, I'll speak no more. Realities of God are beyond human rational mind. It may take us to many places, but not beyond this. I'll give you an example, which is easy to understand. Can you see all the pictures in this room? Pictures. President Trump is going. Cricket match is happening. Prime Minister Modi is going for a meeting. Can you see all these pictures now? Here? Can you see them? You thought I am making fool of you. Okay. Can you listen to the music? No. Because there is no music. But if you keep a TV here, you see the pictures and hear the music. Where was it? All around you as electromagnetic waves. They were there. Can you see them? Even if you struggle, can you see them? Make all your effort, can you hear them? No. You need to convert the electromagnetic waves into light waves and sound waves, then only you hear. But is it there? A phone call is coming to you, can you hear now? No. It's there, the microwave has come, but you can't hear. Because I don't see, because I don't understand, you can say it is not there. That is rational mind. But the realities of God are beyond your rational mind. Then how do you know it? Can you read the 10th verse? 2nd chapter 10.
For to us God revealed them through the Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, even the depths of God.
Revelational, not rational, but revelation. Who has to reveal it? The Spirit of God. So what is beyond my rational mind can be revealed to me only by the Spirit of God. What is unseen, unheard around you can be brought to you only by the tube and the transistor. It has to be converted. But one problem is 2:14. 1 Corinthians 2:14.
But the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, nor can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned.
Natural man. Who is natural man? Who is a natural man? Prakrita manushyan. Ara. Prakrithiyalulla manushyan. Ara. Who is not born again. Who is not born again. Who does not have the Spirit of God with him. So a person who is working only at the rational level, he is a rational being, he is a natural man. But the spiritual man is one who is born again, who has the Spirit of God in him. So the difference is, natural man thinks rationally and he says what is not rational is foolishness. If I tell you, I saw a man walking on the sea yesterday, will you believe? It's not rational. Man who was buried 3 days back came to my house and had lunch. Will you believe? How do you believe when you read Jesus Christ walked on the sea? Do you believe? Will the dead rise again? Maybe. Do you believe? That's why those who read Bible tell all the miracles are myth. Myth, don't believe it. Do Christians believe it? Will it be repeated in your life? No. When it comes to understanding Bible, you all have a lot of questions. How can it be? You are thinking in the rational way. You know, most of the rationalists are atheists. Most of the famous rationalists are atheists. Because the height of rationalism, nothing can be accepted beyond ration. It's very important you to understand this. Paul writes that when he came into Corinth, where rationalism was the height, because everyone rationalized everything and talked on rationalistic way. He said, I came in the midst of you with fear and trembling, lest I also will use same method to communicate the gospel with my rational mind. My speech. Read from 1 to 4. 2 Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 1 to 4.
When I came to you, brothers, I did not come with eloquence or superior wisdom as I proclaimed to you the testimony of God. For I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and with much trembling. My message and my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words, but with a demonstration of the Spirit's power.
Next verse also.
So that your faith might not rest on men's wisdom, but on God's power.
Yes. Now the gospel has been presented with such rationalistic mindset. When I was sharing this, there was a couple from Europe. They were sitting there. They said, most of our faith in Europe is rationalistic faith. Rational faith. If it is not rational, we cannot believe. Tozer wrote many years ago, Christians have an inferential God. Inferential God means sun is there, moon is there, stars are there, so there must be a God who created it. It's inference from that. Inferential God will vaporize into thin air in moments of crisis, he said. When a deeper problem comes, where are you, God? Suddenly he vaporizes. You cannot sustain yourself with rational faith. That's what Paul says, I didn't want your faith to be rational. What's rational faith? Another example. You prayed for something very important in your life, the answer came. You now say, God is good. God is good. After a few months, there was another problem, you prayed, nothing happened. Where are you, God? God suddenly disappeared. Why? You had a rational faith. Rational faith. So about faith, it says, the essence of faith is you believe God is. God is. Very simple. God is. Whether earth, moon, sun and stars are existing or not existing, God is. Whether you are alive or not, God is. That's why his name is I Am. I Am. He doesn't need your belief for him to exist. He doesn't need you and me for him to exist. He doesn't need your worship for him to exist. He is. This is the beginning of faith. He is. And then he rewards those who seek him earnestly. He doesn't say that I will answer you. He rewards those who seek him. So Paul mentions that that's not the way of argument, rationalistic way. I'm not against apologetics, but God doesn't need any support. It may be needed for some mindset of people, that kind of argument may be needed, but still, God doesn't need any support. How do I know? Revelation can only be received. It cannot be produced. Cannot be produced. It has to be revealed. Given to you. Who decides what to reveal? Who decides? God. Who decides when to reveal? Who decides how to reveal? Who decides to whom to reveal? Then what can you do? What can you do? When? So what will you do? Oh, that word is coming, which is not common. Wait. What's the other word with wait? Oh, patiently. Do you have that? Wait patiently. Our approach is, many people have shared this, Lord, I have 15 minutes in the morning. If you are revealing, quickly reveal. If you don't reveal, I will reveal myself and go. And say, God has spoken to me very clearly. Wait cheedittundo? How long Abraham had to wait for Isaac? 25 years, okay. Did he wait?
No.
He was in a hurry to help God. How long the Israelites waited in Egypt to be delivered? 430 years. Remember, God is not in any hurry. You may be in a hurry, God is not in any hurry. There is a song in Malayalam which says, when we pray, you must answer immediately. പ്രാർത്ഥനയ്ക്ക് ഉത്തരം നൽകുന്നവനെ പിന്നെങ്ങനെ ക്ഷണത്തിൽ ഉത്തരം തരണം പ്രാർത്ഥനയ്ക്ക്. ഗോഡ് ഈസ് ഇൻ ദ ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ടി നോ എക്സ്പ്രസ് ഡെലിവറി. പിന്നെ അതർ സോങ് വിൽ സേ ആസ് നിന്റെ ഹിതം പോലെ. But when it comes to prayer, it must be immediately. Wait patiently. Are you present when he brings it? Are you present when he brings the answer? You may be preoccupied. You're not present. Are you open? Are you willing, waiting for your answer or his answer? Are you waiting for your answer or his answer? So what happens when he gives his answer, you won't receive it? No, Lord, I want my answer. I want my answer. Once I was invited to speak in a CSI church near our town. It's that place is called Palani. So the priest of the church has said that I'll send someone to receive you at the bus stand. So when I got down, I was wearing a saffron jubba at that time, and I was having a shoulder bag. The person came and asked, do you want to go to the temple? The word he used is Kovil. Kovil is the same word used for church also. Yes, I thought I went with him. Then only I knew that he is going to shave off my hair. Palani temple, that's a ritual. They will take them, shorn the head. I escaped from him and ran to the place. So, I was had a preconceived idea that a person will wait to take. But that was not right. I need to be open. I need to be open. Are you open? Then are you willing? Willing to receive his answer, or you want your answer? Can God answer your exam with failure? Will you receive it? When I went for my MS exam, the morning meditation was, you will face shame as I face shame. Very beautiful verse for exam. I done my theory well. All my exams I always passed with clearly. So I didn't take it very seriously, but that was in my heart. All exams were over. I went back home. 2 weeks later I came, I thought I have passed. Some of the tutors also mentioned you had done well. 2 weeks back, later I came back, one of my friends said, director wants to meet you. He said, John, I am very sorry to tell you, So this was the meditation I had in the morning before. He's also a Christian. See, we tried to convince the external examiners he's a good student. But it seems that I argued little with the examiner. He was not happy with that. So he failed me. So there was the first year gathering on 2 days later, first year students. So I was sharing with them, God has allowed this to happen in my life. It was a good experience for me, how God guided me before that. And some of them got up and said, we come for the meetings to pass exam, but you say it is also for failure. One of my senior professors was sitting in the class, meeting there. He said, can you come home? For supper. He said, when I passed my exam, I wanted to go for missions. Then I got married. My wife wanted to make money. I am sitting and making money now. I was listening to what you shared. It turned me upside down. He confessed. Wanted me to pray for him. 3 months later, I wrote my exam. The verse was, for your shame, I will give you double portion. So I sent a telegram to my wife before exam itself, I passed. This is the verse. Yes. So God allows certain thing. Am I willing to receive it? Then another part of listening, we come to Mark 135. Mark 135.
I went off to the solitary place where he prayed.
Okay. Why did he go to a solitary place? Why can't he pray inside the house? Yeah, simple reason. Why? Why can't he pray inside the house? Why did he go to a solitary place? So you want what? Outer silence. For listening, you need outer silence. You write the word listen. And what is the other word you can make with all the letters? Listen, what's the other word you can make with all the letters? Silent. Yes. To listen, you must have silence. What time he would have gone out? What time it would have been? No. Why should? Okay. Much before sunrise. Any idea what time he would have gone to bed? What time he would have gone to bed? 32 and 33.
Vaigunneram Suryan Astamicha Shesham Avar Sakala Vida Dina Kareyum Bhuda Grastreyum Avante Adukal Konduvannu.
OPD thodangiyathu eppozha?
After
sunset. Okay. How many patients came? The old city. So when the OPD would have over? Midnight. Okay. What time he woke up? 4 or 5 o'clock. When did the disciples wake up? 36 and 37.
ശീമോനും കൂടെ ഉള്ളവരും അവന്റെ പിന്നാലെ ചെന്നു. അവനെ കണ്ടപ്പോൾ എല്ലാവരും നിന്നെ അന്വേഷിക്കുന്നു എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു.
അവരെ ഉണർത്തിയത് ആരാ?
എല്ലാവരും.
When did they come? What time they would have come and the patients would have come and woke him up? Peter. No. They get up early. Patients. At least 7 o'clock. We get a lot of information from a small passage if you study carefully. So the disciples woke up at 7, the master woke up at 5 or 4, even after midnight work. What time we wake up? 7. Do you know some phenomenon called sunrise? It happens on the east. Have you seen it? Have you seen sunrise? Photographs? No. Anybody has seen? So tomorrow we will see it. You are all invited for a walk in the morning. Okay? We go for a walk at 5:45. Okay. How many of you want to join? My goodness, all of them. Very good. Very good. Morning 5:45. It's good for you. All the participants usually come for a walk. Okay. So you need outer silence. Can you read from Malayalam Psalm 5 verse 3?
യഹോവേ, രാവിലെ എൻ്റെ പ്രാർത്ഥന കേൾക്കണമേ. രാവിലെ ഞാൻ നിനക്കായി ഒരുക്കി കാത്തിരിക്കുന്നു.
ഒരുക്കി കാത്തിരിക്കും. I will come and be prepared and wait for you. ഒരുക്കി, prepared and wait. What is the preparation in the morning you will do? What preparation is needed in the morning? എന്താ ഒരുക്കമോ? Usually when you come for early morning prayer time, what happens? You feel? And then you have dreams and visions only. How do you keep awake? Coffee. Psalm 4, last verse.
Psalms 4, 8 verse. I will lie down in peace and sleep, for you alone, O Lord, will keep me safe.
So what is the preparation you need in the morning? Sleep early in the night and sleep well. How many of you sleep in the same night?
Sorry?
Same night, how many of you sleep?
Same night.
You all sleep next day, no? After 12 is next day. How many of you sleep on the same night? Very few people. Okay. Sleep well to have a restful morning, restful body. So you need a restful body to listen. Body rest. Do you have body rest? When you get up, are you tired? Are you still sleepy? Then you can't listen. A restful body is needed. Why the body is not restful? Fourth verse, Psalm 4 verse 4.
Be angry and do not sin. Meditate within your heart on your bed and be still, Selah.
Another translation?
Don't sin by letting angry get control over you. Think about it overnight and remain silent.
So don't allow sin, anger to take control of you. That is one translation. Any other translation? Tremble and do not sin. Okay. Be angry and not sin. Another translation? In your anger, do not sin. In your anger, do not sin. What is the sin that you commit in anger? How? Something about the night it is said. So what do you do in the night when you come to bed? Ah, meditation, new meditation is there. Replay it in your heart. Then you say, should not I think of like that? Even then, how can you do that? And replay. Fast forward and replay. Fast forward and replay. How many times you replay? Then what do? In the bed? What else you do in the bed? Plan for? Revenge. That's a sin you need not commit, should not commit. In your anger, do not sin is, one sin is plan for revenge. Plan for revenge. Then you cannot sleep. Even if you sleep, you will be tired. So the preparation begins in the daytime itself, in your interaction with people. If that preparation is not right, you will bring your anger to the bed, you won't sleep well, then when you get up, you are still tired, pains and aches in the body. Third area is mind. What is your experience of the mind when you want to be quiet? What's your experience? When you want to be quiet, what happens? Necessary things you think of. You think and plan and many things come into your mind, all the chores that you have to do comes into your mind, and your mind is full of activity. Yes? Is it quiet? But you say, I had a quiet time. What quiet time you had? Wonderful quiet time, brother. Quiet time varuno. So your mind, when it is not quiet, how can you listen? So you read a restful mind. You need a restful mind to listen. How do you have a restful mind? Tell me your practical ways. How is it happening? So what happens is, if you are not restful, you can only think your thoughts. You cannot listen. You cannot listen. So, to listen, all these preparations are needed. Wait patiently, be present, be open, be willing. You need outer silence, body rest, and restful mind. These days, we will learn to prepare ourselves to listen. Learn to prepare ourselves to listen. What's your experience of this learning connected to your life? You can write here. You learn certain things as information. What's the reality in your life? What are your struggles? What are your difficulties? What do you experience?